Imagine that you have a time machine and you can go to any place in history that you want. Take a second and imagine what that time machine looks like. There's a lever, and you can pull the lever and travel back in time to anywhere. Well, one Canadian couple, Blair and Morgan McMillan, they didn't have a time machine, but they wanted to go to a different time. They wanted to go to a simpler time. They wanted to live every day for an entire year like it was 1986. Literally, they took every day for an entire year and lived like it was 1986. They took their smartphones and traded them in for the rotary telephone. The internet? Who needs that when you have the world at the tip of your fingers with Encyclopedia Britannica? And if Blair wanted to listen to Walk Like an Egyptian, well, he had his cassette deck equipped boombox. But what's really interesting about 1986 is what hasn't changed since then. In 1986, the Reagan administration proposed tax reform, and Congress enacted the Tax Reform Act of 1986. And that set today's corporate income tax rate. Let that sink in. The 1986 Tax Act set today's corporate income tax rate. It hasn't changed since 1986. At this point, you're probably thinking, Craig, what the hell are you talking about? Why should I care what the corporate tax rate is? Well, it's really quite simple. We live in a global economy today, unlike 1986. Unlike 1986, companies can go anywhere in the world and invest into that country, but still have access to world markets. So it's up to us to attract companies to invest in our country. But one of the key things that they look at is, what are the corporate tax rates? The U.S. tax rate hasn't changed since 1986. On the other hand, the rest of the world has gradually sloped downwards. Now you probably think, well, we've got a lot of bills to pay. We have to have a high tax rate, right? How are we going to pay for everything if we don't have a high tax rate? Well, the other interesting aspect about the tax system today is our worldwide system of taxation. We tax everything in the world, even though it might not be earned in the United States. So in a way, it's kind of like if you're in college and you went out to get some pizza, you brought it back to your dorm room, so you had some leftovers. Inevitably, your roommate's going to help themselves to a slice or two during the middle of that. It's that way, like with companies, that when a U.S. company earns money abroad in non-U.S. jurisdictions, and it brings that money back to the U.S., it has to pay U.S. tax on what it brings back again. Unlike other countries that don't have that same system, they have a territorial system that taxes only the income that's earned in their country. So it's kind of like you could bring the pizza back to your dorm room and not have to worry about your roommate. But again, how does that relate to revenue? We got to pay those bills. Well, it's really quite interesting when you compare tax rates to the amount of revenue that we bring in as a government. Here you'll see the worldwide tax rate remaining high. And the territorial tax rate dropping. So would you think that the territorial folks are going to bring in less money? What's interesting is that if you look at the worldwide revenue and compare it to the territorial system, the territorial system is actually a little bit higher. So it's counterintuitive, but we should really consider and look at not only the corporate tax rate, but also the system that we run, whether it's worldwide or territorial. But in any event, the McMillans, they ended their experiment in 1986 after a year, and we should consider bringing back our tax system to the future.